I've spent a bulk of my career in ICICI, 33 years in ICICI. And some of you may remember that ICICI was known for the number of women leaders that it had spawned, right? At one time, out of the 5 executive directors on the board, 3 were women. ICICI did nothing special. Not recruitment, not career progression, not in terms of compensation, nothing whatsoever. We didn't track anything, not attrition, nothing whatsoever. And therefore, we believe that we are truly a gender-neutral organization. Women will do well because they are just as capable, if not more, than their male colleagues. And therefore, the do nothing was our mantra. I do think, as corporates, as a society, we need to intervene. Particularly given that women go through this marriage, childbearing, child-rearing age where they need a helping hand. And how we as organizations need to be sensitive to that, come up with policies, processes, trainings for managers to really address that. It's very, very informal because my strong belief is that your team spends more time in the workplace than they do with their families. And therefore, if you are a mere taskmaster to them, you'll get only so much out of it. But if you connect with them, they are a part of your family, and really encourage them. One of the other great things I learned on my job was that you need to make yourself redundant in your role as a manager. Then only you move up. And that obviously means you have to delegate, you have to grow leaders. Not all of us will have the same skill set, the same competencies. And therefore, how do you create these complementary skills and competencies and work together as a team? Eventually make yourself redundant as a job so that you can do more and someone else takes over what you do. Common to both women and generally, I think we have to identify with the purpose of the firm. So, you know, Deloitte's purpose of being there for your clients, you know, serving them, not just best in class, but figuring out the next in class. So that complete identity, I think, with the purpose of the firm. Second is, you know, really the empathy and the growth of the teams that are working with you. I hate the term boss because we are all equals. Today, if you look at the knowledge and the skill set that might exist at the last mile, will probably be far greater than those of us sitting in our corner rooms. So how is it that you really leverage that last mile and make them just as powerful? Speaks to what I said earlier in terms of making yourself. You know, India is a young country. I think India has a phenomenal opportunity of really getting into the middle income status. And what is it that we can harness the power of Deloitte and, you know, the teams that you have, the knowledge and the wealth of knowledge that you have in terms of doing stuff that will drive this country forward. In some ways, it identifies with that purpose that was more client-related. This is much more country-related. And for the women, my strongest piece of advice is don't think of yourself as a woman. I mean, you are an outstanding professional, born together because there's so much we can learn from each other.